Hey everybody, so for today's assignment I have to find two movies with character-driven plots and analyze the main lines of action and themes for each. Then I have to describe the opening scene, two turning points, and the closing scene of each movie. Before I get into it, I should make a disclaimer that really applies not just to this chapter, but to the entire course. I apologize if you haven't seen the movies I'm analyzing. I certainly don't want to ruin the experience for anyone of watching a movie for the first time. But given that we are using landmark movies as teaching tools, some plot details will of necessity be revealed. However, I do encourage you to watch the movies I cover that you haven't yet seen, and I hope that your experience of watching those movies will only be enhanced by these instructional videos. That being said, the first movie I'll be analyzing is On the Waterfront, starring Marlon Brando. Here's the main line of action. Terry Molloy, a slightly dim-witted longshoreman lackey with a regrettable past, tries to deal responsibly with his corrupt union bosses who rule the docks with absolute authority, and by doing so gains self-respect and independence, emphasizing loyalty to conscience, to family, to friends and fellow workers, and, by contrast, to a corrupt union, a theme that has since become ingrained in American film culture. In the opening scene, Terry tries to do his job of helping union leaders lure an informant and traitor to the union onto the roof of his apartment building, but two goons toss the traitor off the roof, and Terry is shocked, because he thought they were only going to talk to him, and not kill him. This scene shows Terry's initial naivety and his beginning concern about how to deal with the union's actions. Here's the first turning point. So Terry, being slightly dissatisfied with the way things are going, still tries to carry out what his union leaders want him to do. But another dockman, convinced by a priest to testify, is murdered, crushed by a crate in a stage accident so as to ensure that no one would speak out against the union. Standing over the dead man's body, the priest gives an impassioned sermon, despite threats from the boss's men to step down. And Terry, unable to stand the priest being abused any longer, flattens one of the boss's men with a punch to the face. This scene shows Terry's willingness to oppose the union leaders. In the second turning point, Terry, having become openly rebellious against the union, tries to explain to his brother Charlie, who was the boss's right-hand man, why he is unsure of whether or not he will testify against the union. But Charlie pulls a gun on Terry to force him to keep quiet.
For me a little bit. You should have taken care of me just a little bit so I wouldn't have to take them dives for the short end money.
Well, I had some bets down for you. You saw some money.
You don't understand. I could have had class. I could have been a contender. I could have been somebody. Instead of a bum, which is what I am. Let's face it. It was you, Charlie.